Well, doctors at Johns Hopkins will soon start doing full face transplants. Those unique surgeries have only been performed 22 times around the world. A university institutional review board signed off on the Hopkins program last month. 11 News reporter Kai Reed joins us live from the 11 newsroom with more on the story. Kai.
Well, Donna, the complex surgery has only been performed one other time in Baltimore. The University of Maryland Medical Center performed the surgery in March. Surgeons at Johns Hopkins say they're now in the process of screening potential candidates.
Practice your nerve connections and the artery connections.
Johns Hopkins Hospital surgeon Dr. Chad Gordon is holding the x-ray of a patient with a severe facial injury.
So all you would see is the upper
nose, cheeks, lips, the entire bottom half of their face is gone. Possibly an ideal candidate for a face transplant at the hospital in the near future.
It's a transplant from someone else. It's designed specifically for the person. You can actually design it where you can bring over the bones along with the face to actually reconstruct everything to try to restore the appearance back to how they were previously.
This is video of Dr. Gordon doing a trial run on a cadaver. He's part of a specialized team of 50 to 60 experts brought together over the past year, including plastic surgeons, transplant surgeons, infectious disease specialists, even psychologists.
People who specialize in hooking up tiny blood vessels underneath a microscope, or people who specialize in hooking tiny nerves together so that you're able to smile or blink.
The donor process is similar to how it works with liver, heart, or kidney transplants. The hospital works with an organization and gets special consent from the donor family.
The surgery itself is not the magic cure. It's really the rehabilitation after the surgery that helps their brain adapt to their new face. It's also staying compliant with their medicines to make sure that your immune system doesn't reject the face.
According to Gordon, immunotherapy protocol, a process that reduces the amount of medicine patients need post-surgery, makes Hopkins' program unique.
We tried to minimize the amount of immunosuppression that we put these patients on. And the way we're able to do that is to use the donor's bone marrow at the time of facial recovery, which is unique to Johns Hopkins.
Officials say they currently have three possible candidates. Potential patients are evaluated to determine if they could handle the extensive surgery and post-surgery. Surgery time can span up to 35 hours, and the rehabilitation process can take up to 2 years. Reporting live in the newsroom, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.